Hi everyone. In today's video, we are going to cover a very interesting and a very unique plant. Okay, this plant is called the Muehlenbeckia platycladum. So it is also called the Homocladium platycladum, or it is in simple words called the centipede plant, or also called the ribbon bush, as well as another unique name called the tapeworm plant. And I'll show you why it is called the tapeworm plant. If you look at this plant, it has more of stems. Okay, so these are actually not leaves, but these are stems. And if you see these stems have segments. Do you see these segments? And each of these segments look like tapeworms. As the new leaves develop, the younger plants do have small little leaves that come up. But these leaves quickly drop off and there are blooms that come up at the stem edges. And these blooms are typically red and white in color. Very different kind of a plant. This particular plant is actually native of New Guinea and the Solomon Islands. But it's also naturalized in other regions. Like for instance, it's found all over the tropics or even in the temperates, right? I mean, right from Puerto Rico to India. To Nicaragua and to Madagascar and Pakistan. So all over the place. But this is a very different kind of a plant. Not very easily found in nurseries. I don't know. I just found it in one very nondescript nursery. And I grabbed it without really... I actually thought it was a fern when I first found it. After that, I started reading up on it. And then I realized it's a completely different plant. So the care for this plant is very different. This plant likes its sun, so it can grow in direct sunlight. However, it also likes to be well watered. So I would compare its care very comparable to say a coleus kind of a care regimen, right? Coleus also likes its sun as well as likes its water. Similarly with this plant, the minute you don't water it in the, I have not had this plant for too long. So I've still been, you know, trying to experiment with it. So I tried to dry it between waterings and then I started getting some of these dead leaves or dead stems. And when I started re-watering it and watering it deeply and keeping it moist, the plant is actually doing very well. And I've read up a little bit on this plant and that's what they like. So they do like their moist soil while they like bright sun. They can do well even in direct sunlight, but mine is in a pot and it is inside the balcony. So it doesn't get the direct sun, but I have put it in a bright spot in the balcony. That's a water and that's a light requirement. I haven't fertilized this. They are not very particular about their soil mix either. But given that they are from the tropics, they do love any kind of soil which can take in a lot of water. But don't get them soggy feet. Any plant doesn't like it. So use some well-draining soil. So that you can water deeply and the root ball is well watered, and that's really what this plant needs. So easy plant to grow once you have it, once you find it, and you can keep it short. When I first got it, I had a huge unmanageable and untamable plant. So what I've right now done is kept it, just trimmed it a bit, and it does look, the name tapeworm sounds a little creepy and eerie, but I think it's a lovely little plant, very different, and I'm waiting for the blooms. My plant hasn't bloomed yet, so I'm really looking forward to the blooms, and I understand that they bloom at each of these nodes and they bloom together, which means that it will be quite a sight to see. So that's a tapeworm plant for you, okay, the Muehlenbeckia platycladum. Easy plant, and if you can find it, do grow it, and it does grow from cuttings as well as from seeds. Okay, so thanks for watching this short video. Bye-bye.